Hi folks, it's Mike with Get My Tips, a place you will find some great tips from the kitchen to the garage. And if you're someone who likes to learn new skills so that you can be more handy around the house, well, I invite you to subscribe. Now, this is part three of a four-part series about electrical generators. We're going to show you how to get the electricity from the generator to the inside of your house without having to call an electrician and without having any special electrical skills. But the most important thing we're going to show you on this video is how to get the electricity from the outside to the inside without having any doors or windows open. Now, the method I am going to show you on how to hook up a generator to your home is an alternative to a manual generator transfer switch. I needed a convenient place to bring the power inside my home, so I decided to put the receptacle behind this commercial grade convection oven. My thinking was that I could move the convection oven out of the way when I needed to fire up the generator, and this would also be a convenient place for me to plug in my cell phone charger. Here is the receptacle on the inside of my home, and this is the metal weatherproof box on the outside of my home. Now, this box cost about $17, and later in this video I will share with you how you can get one for yourself. Once I had everything measured out, I used a Dremel to cut out the drywall. I had to cut down a single gang drywall box because my home is made out of concrete block. And what that means is that there's only about an inch and a quarter space between the face of the drywall and the block itself. I cut a small hole into the insulation and then used my hammer drill to drill from the inside to the outside. Then I used some tapcons to mount this weatherproof box. I wanted to keep my connections outside as waterproof as possible, so I sacrificed the male end of an old extension cord. Normally I would use a piece of Romex and wire nuts, but because it's so tight inside that box, I decided to solder some terminals onto the wires. The next step is to fish the wires into the box from the outside to the inside. Before I installed the receptacle on the inside, I used some silicone seal to seal up the hole on the inside of the concrete block. Then I went to the outside and sealed up the outside where the cord comes through, and noticed that I used some strapping to tether the wire down. Now let's check out how I connected my generator to my home without having to use an automatic transfer switch or a manual generator transfer switch. Now, if you remember from part one on this series, when I calculated how much energy I would require in the event of a power loss, my demand was rather low. So let's see if it will power my refrigerator. Let's plug in the extension cord. With the kilowatt meter set for wattage, we're looking for 500 watts because that's what my refrigerator uses. And there it is. Well, there you go. And if you'd like to buy one of those waterproof metal boxes, we put them on our Amazon store. And we'll put a link to the Amazon store in the video description. And keep in mind, whenever you buy something through our store on Amazon, we get a small commission, and that helps us make more videos. Thanks for watching.